Let me share with you a little bit what I do. This is a complicated hand. He had an amputation, a severe fracture. You can see the scars over here on the side. Now, we worked for a really long time, really hard to avoid having a trigger release, but lo and behold, we needed to have that surgery done anyway. But he had to have the release of all three, right? And one thing I want you to pay attention to, sometimes it gets forgotten, and the reason why sort of like the hand pain continues to persist is that when you have a pretty severe injury, there can be scarring and adhesions in multiple locations, even though there isn't scarring, there isn't a cut, right? So if I go and I look, and you might have to get close, and we've talked about this before, I've shown you this before, but we can see it. Like, you can see, because his hand was really swollen. And then we finally got, like a while ago, we got the wrinkles back, right? And you can look here, like this is nice and soft. And then we get here. And as a therapist, you have to learn to feel with the tips of your fingers. Like, oh, this, you can see, can you see it? Mm-hmm. Can you feel it?
Yeah.
You can feel it, right? Okay, so right here, and then right here. Ooh, this one, you can see it too, right? And it, like, I get stuck right here. And then if I run, so if this is the metacarpal and then this is a proximal phalanx, the intrinsics run on the side of it and it gets stuck on the skin, the fascia, the tendon. Oh, I don't care what it is, right? All I know is it's stuck over here and it can be stuck here on this side, right? And a lot of people have a tendency to like work their hand like right here in the middle. Not present company, of course, but yes, present company. So a lot of times they tend to do this all day, and all the muscles, they tend to pull the proximal phalanx very forward. So one thing from a manual perspective you can do is you can distract and you can pull it back, right? And then once you pull it back, does that feel good?
Mm-hmm.
It not only puts less tension over here, which then you can also, so I often talk about putting structures short and long, so you can shorten the extensor tendons and structures here, and then put on stretch the flexor structures over here, right? Because it's real tight over here as well. So when you're evaluating a hand, you want to look at all the structures. You want to look at how the bone is, like how the joint is sitting, right? How the muscles and tendons are moving, right? Are they moving the way they're supposed to be moving, or is there an imbalance? Like, sometimes the intrinsics are really tight and then your extrinsics are pulling too hard, right? So they're working out of balance. The ligaments are tight, right? In certain places, not all places. So a lot of times, even though we have flexion and extension, and we have ab and ad, actively open your fingers, right? And then squeeze them together, open. So, you know, flexion and then extension, right? So those are all the active movements, but between the proximal phalanx and the metacarpal, the ligaments hold this MP, so it has stability. When it holds it, it also provides some passive motion that sometimes we tend to forget. So if I can hold the metacarpals, and then I can hold this one, I can passively rotate. One direction is a little looser than the other direction. It's real tight this way, and it's looser this way, right? So ligaments, you have to look at ligaments too. Just because there's nothing wrong with them doesn't mean they're not tight in one direction or another direction, okay? And then don't forget, you gotta look at all the skin and the fascia and the scarring, not just where you might have had the injury, but all around it, so that you can actively move everything so that you can get rid of the pain, and they can actually rebalance how the hand works. Because if the hand continues to work out of balance in the sense that the intrinsics are too tight and the flexors work too hard, and then every time someone squeezes their hand, instead of just pulling down with the tips of their fingers, they're squeezing their fingers together and trying so hard, they keep working that imbalance in, and then they can't get rid of their hand pain. So you, as an occupational therapist, as a certified hand therapist, need to look at all the structures and how well they all play together in order to work with a complex hand, a chronic hand, looking to avoid surgery, looking to get the best possible results after surgery. So if you like videos like this, hit the like button and subscribe. If you have any questions, leave them below so I can make more videos just like this. Hey therapy friends, it's Hwang here. Thanks again for watching my video. And if you like videos like this that can help you just crush it in the hand therapy world as an occupational therapist, then hit the subscribe button and enjoy the video. Thanks again for watching.